Hey, it's Jordan here and welcome back to the channel. Today we are at a massive neo chateau style mansion that was built in 1964. Now this house hasn't been abandoned for that long. I think maybe just like a year or so. This place is pretty incredible. I just took a quick tour around and you're really gonna love it, and hopefully not to try to make this a really long video, but it is a really big house. So I'm really excited to show you, and let's get to it. So we're gonna start the video off at the front door, and just the amount of detail in this mansion is absolutely incredible. Now, they do have the demo fencing up. So as you can see, the orange fencing only means one thing. So this beautiful mansion is going to get demolished. So let's go into the main room, and it is really cold today, so I might be a little sniffly today, but I don't want to miss out on the details of this place, but kind of want to make this a little bit quicker considering it's cold and my batteries don't like to last that long. So out here is the backyard. You have the tennis court, then you have like a tea room, guest room out there. Now the first room we're gonna go into, big huge fireplace, real fireplace, but again I want to show you all the details of this place. Now I do have information about who lived here, but I will put that in the description. Beautiful home, like it's crazy how they're gonna demolish it. Now there is some like water damage and stuff, but like not a lot. I haven't even ventured into the basement yet, but the second room that we're gonna go into is the cigar room. Huge cabinets. I'm guessing they probably sold a lot of the things that were in this place. Kind of makes me wonder where the old owners moved to. So that's the cigar room, even says on that little sticky note there. I really like the pillars. They're all throughout the house as well. So this is bedroom number one. Again, a really nice fireplace, electric fireplace. This is one of the smaller bathrooms, but again, a really nice big glass shower. And right next door lives a very famous Canadian artist. So in here is the walk-in closet. It's actually probably one of the smaller ones, actually. So we're gonna head back to the front of the door and we're gonna go into this bathroom. Well, here's the powder room. So I would say this is like the worst looking bathroom in this place, which is pretty sad considering what the other bathrooms look like. So this is what, the third bathroom on this floor already? Nice countertop and vanity in general. It's like pretty much identical to the other one. Again, another big walk-in closet. These. Ah. I thought maybe it was some secret door or something. So we're going to head down to the other rooms that are down here, but I can't forget to show you all these black rocks. I've never seen anything like this. It's the first time I've ever seen this in a house before. And the staircase is really big, as you can see. So there is nothing left behind in this house, but doesn't mean that it's not a good house by any means. So this place actually has an elevator, but the doors won't open. So I can't show you that. I'm not sure what room this would have been. I wouldn't really say it's a bedroom. It's just like electrical. Yep. So we'll do the kitchen shortly, but this is another main entrance. Danger, don't touch red switch. It says goodbye. Okay. What's in here? The mudroom? Okay. Mudroom with a sink. And then you have a pretty big garage. Love the ice block. It's pretty windy. I just started my video and my battery is already at 85%. My light's already dying. I don't know, for some reason they just don't like the cold. So here is bathroom, what, number four? Just on this floor alone, I believe. So we're gonna go into the kitchen, and there's like kind of two parts to this kitchen. So there you have a massive fridge. There's definitely nothing in it. And there's no power. A lot of cupboard space. I just like how this is just its own like little mini kitchen. Over here. Got a little wine bar cooler thing. Yeah, so this is the kitchen. You got your oven. You got another fridge. Two big islands. Craziness. So this is the other part of the kitchen. A lot more cupboard space. Then you have even more storage in here. I don't know how many people lived here, but I can maybe try to find something out. The outside property is really nice. So before we go into the pool room, there's this room. I don't know, it kind of reminds me of like a ballroom. A little small for a ballroom, but some sort of fancy room. I really like the shaped glass. So I don't know what they were doing here. Maybe they were trying to renovate, well, obviously renovate this sort of spot, or but never finished it or something. But it is absolutely freezing in here. It's probably just as cold in here as it is outside. I don't know if that's right. That's in Fahrenheit though, 32. I guess that might be right. So I don't know what room this would have been. Maybe, you know what? I'm guessing just by the mirror, it probably was a gym. And I'm assuming that they probably had more mirrors, probably just by the nails there. They probably had mirrors on that wall too, and this one as well. But over here you have the sauna. I haven't been in one of these in a while. Like one that works. Even the toilet has pee and mold in it. So here's the stand-up shower. Pretty nice, with a huge acid-etched glass door. That's cool. And then over here, just have like a change room. So now we're gonna check out the pool room, and yeah, it's pretty incredible. And on the roof, got some painted clouds. So over here you can start seeing some damage that fell from up there. Look at this. It is pretty deep in there. So cool. nice decent size indoor pool. And then now you can get a better look of, or at the tree protection fence. So when they do tear this place down, they can't cut down any of those trees, so which is nice. Well, you even got little things in the tile. You got a horse, a seahorse, and a dolphin. I don't know if the other ones on the other side are different. Well, you got a shark. Okay, so they're kind of the same. So I think that's it for the main floor. Let's check the upstairs now. So to the second floor we go. A lot of stairs. I definitely want to save the best room for last, even though they're all really nice. So here's a view from the second story. I'm guessing they would have had a really nice chandelier. I'm guessing these bookshelves were filled with books, obviously. Got more shelving, a real fireplace, another TV. The amount of TVs that they just left behind is crazy, because I guarantee those still work. So we're gonna check out this bedroom over here. Pretty nice size. You would have had your bed there. And then we got the bathroom. So I found this part of the bathroom kind of interesting. So you have this glass that looks into the toilet and bidet, but I mean, I really should know more about glass, considering it's part of my job, but I don't think you can really, okay, you can kind of see through, like obviously with the light, but I don't know how much you'd be able to see with like the real lights on. But I think most of these bathrooms all had the powered towel warmers, which is cool. Big vanity. Then you have this pretty cool acid etched glass wall. Got some flies on the floor. So here you have your toilet and bidet. And then you have your window. I actually don't mind it. Actually, it's kind of cool. And then just have your standard glass shower. I've done lots of those. So here is an actual real huge walk-in closet. I mean, this is bigger than some people's bedrooms. That's crazy. I was thinking that it wouldn't surprise me if I ran into someone that I know here, but I feel like I'm one of the last people to visit this place. Definitely won't be the last, I'm sure. So down here to the right, there's, I think it's just closet space, yeah. I mean, if I was rich, I'd probably have a decent amount of closet space, but I mean, there's a lot. So in this bedroom, gas fireplace. Yeah. This one also has a really big walk-in closet. Not as big as the other one, obviously. But yeah, there's definitely nothing left behind. Again, another TV. Another shower, another bath. That is a big mirror with cutouts. I wonder how much these things are. I'm gonna Google this after. Warm rails. I mean, I can't imagine they're that much money. But nice big shower. I've done quite a few like this before. So that's it for this bedroom. We shall carry on. To the next room. Big closet space. And again, you have another TV left behind. And again, another walk-in closet. It would have been better if this place still had hydro, but can't win them all. So you got your shower, your toilet here. I can't wait to show you the last bathroom up here. It's pretty crazy. Pretty big bathroom, actually. One looks pretty identical to the last room that we were in. So I had to stop the video because I thought someone else was here, but it ended up just being the garage door that I didn't close slammed because it's windy, or maybe someone is here. I have no idea. So this bathroom belonged to someone elderly because they got one of those toilet things. Plus the toilet's pretty low to the ground. But again, nice bathroom and one of those heaters. And you guessed it, another walk-in closet. Yeah, I would have heard someone if they were here. Plus they would have came through that one, that door. So here you have a cedar room, but I don't know There's no like hooks or anything for like a closet or something. I don't know. What do people use cedar rooms for other than closets? So, another room that basically looks the same as the other ones. Again, with another TV. This bathroom's pretty nice. A lot of detail in this house from all the crown molding and everything. And you've already seen a walk-in closet before. I'm just curious if someone is here. So there's the door to the elevator. And for the second last room up here, the laundry room, which has the staircase that goes into the attic. I kind of took a peek up there. It's just really dark. And it's just like ventilation and stuff. So yeah, your washer and dryer would have been here. Yep. Front loading automatic washer by Whirlpool. There's the front yard, which people have ventured out to, but I don't want to do that. So again, the elevator and the button. But yeah, I don't know. I'm wondering why it doesn't work. So for the last room up here, has the coolest bathroom that I have ever seen. So we got gas fireplace. Walk-in closet. And what's in here? Oh. Okay. And powder room station. I'm guessing this was like the wife's walk-in area. And this probably would have been like the husband's. But check out this tub and igloo shaped glass. That is crazy. And then you have a huge shower. Then you have your bidet and toilet. And the roof's coming in. I didn't even notice that the first time I was here. Yeah, it is pretty crazy that they're like tearing this house down. So that is it for the upstairs. Now let's check out the downstairs, and I actually haven't been down there, so it is going to be quite the surprise. So I went to go check the garage door, and it definitely wouldn't have slammed like that. So I don't know what I heard, but it was really loud. So into the basement we go. I really don't know how big it is. Okay, so you just have a little crawl space over here. Okay, well, there's a big, huge bar over here, so let's go check that out first. Holy. I be just the wind, but still, it's freaking me out. I don't know what this room is. Okay. So we never finished in this area. Where does this go? Nowhere. I'm not hearing things, I swear. Like, it is freaking me out though. I think we're almost done down here anyways. Whoa! A theater room. Look, you got the built-in speakers. You would have had like your couches and stuff here. Whoa, you even got the speakers in the, what? This is crazy. Yeah, you would have had like earlier stuff. Is this still? Well, some stuff left. You got the receiver and stuff left. But that's cool. I guess if you're rich, you can afford to have a theater room, right? Do not touch. Furnace room. Logs. It's a funny story about the logs. Not really funny, but it's about the owner who didn't live here. Got a wine rack room. Oh, that's cool. Big huge space down here. Maybe this place is haunted. I don't know. Bathroom. Smells in here. Oh boy. I think someone took a number two in there. It smells. Wow. Look at all the wires and all the plumbing and... That's pretty crazy. So obviously this place has been updated throughout the time that it was built in 64. I'm getting really spooked out. There's the elevator. Damn it. I guess because I'm in the basement, I wouldn't be able to hear if anyone was upstairs now. Storage room. Craziness. I can't wait to be done this video. My hands are freezing. Bathroom that never was finished. Or washer and dryer, actually. What's down here? Okay, so you have another bathroom. Oh yeah. Wow. It's like its own little apartment down here. Got a little fridge and stove. Okay, let's go over here. And then this would have been the bedroom. I'd love to live down here. I don't know. Oh, okay. Closet. So to the right is the staircase to go upstairs. So we are almost done. And in here, probably would have been another bathroom, just judging by the tiles. And another furnace room. Return floor heating. What a big house. Jeez. So that's gotta be it. So now let's make our way. Oh, Jesus, I can feel how cold it is up here. And then we're back up to the pool room. So that's it for the tour. I hope you enjoyed it. So I hope you enjoyed this video of this abandoned mansion that was built in 1964. And as always, you can follow me on social media at Liltattyy. And if you aren't subscribed to me, please do. And of course, I'll catch you guys on the next one.